The reason why I said the worship that Moses gave did not fail is because you hear the Lord Jesus said, no, there's no letter, no iota. It says, this law shall not fail. It says, I have not come to deal away with the law, but to fulfill it. Amen. So he came to fulfill it in order that the righteousness requirement of the law may be fulfilled in us. In fact, even the righteousness that we behold is the same righteousness that the law trumpeted. That righteousness that the law of Moses, as we call it, was trumpeting, is the righteousness with which the Lord Jesus came to accomplish in us. It was not a foreign righteousness. So it is not as if Moses came to tell us about one righteousness and Jesus came to tell us about a different righteousness. No. It is, so Moses came to tell us this righteousness, but they could not achieve it. So now Jesus came, and then he fulfilled it, and then he says, I give it to you now. Amen. It's the same righteousness. He did not fail. He gave it on the mountain. Moses gave it to them. It never failed. Christ came, fulfilled it, and gave it to us. He gave it to us as a gift. Then he says, now walk in this worship. Amen. So Christ came and he fulfilled it. Not to deal it away. He said, he did not come to abolish it, to trash it, to make it as a useless thing. He says, he did not look at it as a useless thing and say, Moses is Old Testament. I am the New Testament. Moses is Old Testament. No. You cannot have the New Testament without the Old, because in the sense that the mission of the New is hinged on the Old. Because this one was a transition in order to bring us to the full realization of the righteousness of God. But the purpose for which it was given, yeah, as I said, was the same. It's the same as Christ came to restore that worship. The elements he gave Moses, he says, Jesus came to fulfill it. Hallelujah. So as Moses was faithful and the Lord was faithful, now he says, be faithful to unto this righteousness. Hallelujah. He did not fail. Because whatever God begins never fails. Hallelujah. The Lord is not a failure. Hallelujah. No failure. Not at all. No. What man begins fails. Will fail. But what the Lord begins, prosecute. It shall never fail. It has never failed. It will never fail. The people may fail. And people may fail you. Will fail you. Yeah? You read the scripture and it says, the Lord destroys, yeah? The Lord protects me from all my enemies. And then you are looking around and it looks like you are, his sickness here, whatever here. And you think, oh Lord, what is happening with me? It is not that the word of God has failed. Yeah? Just because you are going through challenges and troubles and whatever, and life seems difficult, it's not because the word of God has failed. Hallelujah. And someone is asking, so what has failed then? Man fails, but the Lord never fails. You see, you don't have the bigger picture yet. You're in the midst of all this stuff that looks like the word of God has failed. Oh, your mother has died. Oh, you have lost your support. Oh, you have lost your job. Oh, people are dying around you. Oh, people, you have been fired. You say, oh, Lord, your word says what now? No, the Lord has not failed. Just because you lost your job. You don't have the bigger picture yet. You don't understand everything yet. Hallelujah. Because he says, you just seek me. You just seek me. Isn't it that even on the cross he said, Lord, why have you forsaken me? It's not because the Lord has failed him. It was a bigger picture. Hallelujah. Which has not yet ended. Then the story continues in Jesus' name. Amen. Praise God.